Hello and welcome to this video on numerical methods. So in this video we are going to be looking at numerical differentiation, and specifically we are going to be looking at the finite difference method of numerical differentiation. Now the finite difference methods are used to approximate derivatives and solve differential equations numerically. The main types of the finite difference methods are forward differences, backward differences, and the central difference. Each type has its own formula and mode of application, primarily based on how data points are used around the point of interest. Now, let's explain each of these types of difference method. Now, the first type, as highlighted earlier, is the forward difference method. The forward difference uses the value of a function at a point and the value at the next point to approximate the derivative. So basically, by formula, that simply means that delta f of x is equal to f of x plus h minus f of x. So it uses the value of the function at a point and the value of the function at the next point to approximate the derivative. So by formula, the forward difference is simply given as this: delta f of x, which means change in the function of x, equals f of x plus h minus f of x. So you use the value of a function at a point, f of x, and the value of the function at the next point. So when you increase the value of x by h, you're not considering the value of the function at the next point. So basically, what this simply means is, for instance, if you're considering a point that involves y naught, y1, y2, then you simply now say that change in y is equal to y1 minus y naught. So using the value of the function at a point and the value of the function at the next point, which is y1, at a point becomes the initial point to approximate the derivative of the function. Now we can have the first derivative for the forward difference, we can have the second derivative, the third derivative, as many as the derivative you are required to find. Let's say you're asked to find the first derivative for the forward difference. The formula in this case becomes, okay, f prime of x. This is going to be equal to f of x plus h minus f of x all over h, where h simply stands for the interval. An interval simply means the difference in the values of x, okay, when a table is given to you. The difference in the value of x is simply called the interval. So we've done more of this on our previous videos on interpolation in numerical methods. So you can do well to look up the playlist on numerical methods to find interpolation to properly understand more of these concepts. All right, so this is now the first derivative approximation of the forward difference method. Okay, now you can as well find the second derivative approximation. That is simply given as f prime prime of x, which is equal to, for the second derivative approximation, you have f of x plus 2h, okay, minus 2f of x plus h, okay, plus f of x all over h. So with this, you can approximate the second derivative for the forward difference method. As well, you can approximate the third derivative using the formula f prime 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 of x equals, this becomes f of x plus 3h minus 3f of x plus 2h plus 3f of x plus h minus f of x all over h cubed. So pardon me, for the second derivative test, you simply add h squared here, so it is the interval or squared. For the first derivative test, you simply have just h. Okay, so this is how you approximate numerical differentiations from the forward difference method. So if you're asked to find the first derivative, you simply make use of this formula for that. The if you ask to find the second derivative, you use this and this for the third derivative approximation. All right. Now let's take a look at the backward difference method. The backward difference uses the value of the function at a point and the value at the previous point to evaluate or estimate the derivative. By formula, we have that delta f of x is simply equal to, this becomes f of x minus f of x minus h. So we are now moving from behind, simply taking backward of what we did previously. Now let's take a look at the forward difference method. We obtain that change in f of x is simply equal to f of x plus h. Now this is leaping forward, adding plus h to the value of x minus f of x, which is main function itself. Now we're moving from behind for the backward difference, so we simply come from behind. It becomes f of x minus f of x minus h. Okay, so you consider the value of the function at a point, which is f of x, and the previous point, okay, which is now f of x minus h, talking about the value behind, to now approximate the derivative. Now just like we did in the previous case, we can also approximate the first derivative, second derivative, or the third derivative. Now let's say to approximate the first derivative using the backward difference method, you have that f prime of x is equal to, that becomes, since we are now moving from behind, it simply becomes f of x minus f of x minus h all over h. So this is now what, the first derivative approximation using the backward difference method. So if you compare this with the forward difference method, you observe the formula is literally moving from behind, f of x coming first, then you have f of x, this changes now from plus to what, negative. So it is literally moving from behind. Okay, now you can also approximate for the second derivative test. Of course, for the second derivative test, you have f prime prime of x. This is going to be equal to, so you have f of x once again coming from behind, minus 2 f of x minus h, okay, plus f of x minus 2 h all over h squared. So this simply gives us the second derivative test using the backward difference method. So if you are given a question and you're asked to find the second derivative test and you're to employ the backward difference method, then this is what you're going to be using. Not forgetting h simply stands as the interval. Interval means, once again, the spacing or distance between successive values of x. Okay, now if you're asked to find the third derivative test, or the third derivative approximation using the backward difference method, the formula is simply f prime 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 of x is equal to, once again you move from behind, it becomes f of x, okay, minus 3 f of x minus h plus 3 f of x minus 2 h minus f of x plus h all over h to the power of 3. So this gives us the formula to evaluate or approximate the third derivative using the backward difference method. Okay, now let's now take a look at the central difference method. Okay, the central difference method uses the value of the function at a point on either side of the point of interest to estimate the value of the derivative. It is often more accurate to use the central difference method than to use the backward or the forward difference method. Now, by formula, the central difference method, delta f of x, is simply given as f of x plus h minus f of x minus h. So you're simply using the value of the function lying on either side of the point of interest. So you see, this is f of x plus h, one step ahead, f of x plus h, one step behind. So any value that is lying between these two points is called the central difference method. For instance, now let's say we have the values of x to be, let's say you have x to have this value 5, and then you have x here to have this value, this is x1 and this is x2, to have this value 6, and you're asked to find the value of y, okay, and you're asked to find the value of y when x is 5.5, right? Now you see that 5.5 lies between these two points and cannot be seen here. In that case, you simply employ what, the central difference method, simply because 5.5 is lying between x1 and x2, which is 5 and 6. So you're using the value of two points, one behind and one in front, to find or approximate the derivative of a given function. So just like in the previous cases, you could be asked to find the first derivative approximation using the central difference method. How do you do this? Okay, for the first derivative, f prime of x is given simply as f of x plus h minus f of x minus h all over 2h. So this becomes the first derivative approximation using the central difference method. Okay, if you're asked to evaluate this double derivative or second derivative approximation using the central difference method, then that becomes f prime prime of x equals f of x plus h minus 2f of x plus f of x minus h all over h squared. So this is how you approximate the second derivative using the central difference method. So if you're asked to approximate the third derivative test using the central difference method, you simply make use of this formula, f of x plus 2h plus 2f of x plus h minus 2f of x minus h all over 2h to the power of 3, where once more h simply stands for the interval. Okay, so that is basically the whole idea behind finite difference. This video is just an introductory video. In the next video, we are going to be employing everything we've learned here to solving problems in numerical differentiation involving the use of the finite difference method. I am sure you want to be a part of that video, so do well to smash the subscribe button right now and turn on your notification bell so you don't miss out on that video when it drops. I will see you in the next video with a couple of examples on numerical differentiation. Thanks.